This is ClickUp Calendar. It is a calendar experience that you can connect to your ClickUp account, and it will help you to organize your tasks, much like you would see in apps like Notion Calendar. Today, we're going to overview it, see whether it's right for you. Just look into some of the features of the application. We're going to see whether it lives up to the hype. Today's video is kindly sponsored by Zapier. You can find out more about them in the description below and a little bit later in this video. So let's take you back to the start, because in January 2024, a application called HyperCal was purchased by ClickUp. And the founder, who I was very lucky to meet after a Notion event, the likes of Ricardo, was able to join the team of ClickUp and become head of ClickUp Calendar. Now, 2 years later, they've released this calendar experience, and they are aiming to make this very similar to Notion Calendar in extent of bringing people into the application and making it even more useful. Sort of like a little bit of a lead magnet, I guess, to some extent, to bring people into the ClickUp experience as solo users and just to enhance their ecosystem of apps. Now, with ClickUp Calendar, you can connect up two experiences, Google Calendar or Outlook Calendar, as more recent. And the objective of this calendar app is to essentially help you to auto-schedule, as well as use AI Meeting Notes, which is an additional premium, and use it as a general calendar experience to manage with time blocking. So I think the best thing to do is jump in and show you. So as you can see here, as the design is relatively simple, how to get to this is a little bit more interesting. So it's sort of baked up in the corner up here of your ClickUp experience. I have connected this, so I don't know why it's showing a little yellow sort of warning sign, but this is what pops up when you press that button. Now, as you can see, on the left-hand side, I have a sidebar, which is of tasks. And on the right-hand side, or you can knock that away, you can see your calendar. Now, just to show you some of the views, you can have day view, you can have 4-day view or week view. That's all that you get inside of the calendar. Now, week view will do you just fine. But as you can see, you can pop this open and see everything there. Now, there are a few things to know about this. They want to help you to plan those tasks that are ready in your ClickUp. So if you already use ClickUp, this is an instant bonus. And as you can see there are a thing called priorities, assigned to me, overdue, and backlog. So this is a little bit sort of rich in detail. So you can have and add any task to your priorities. So if you go to your backlog, you can flag anything as add to priorities. Now, once they're in priorities, you can do a few things. You can remove them, you can go into something called planning mode, or you can use something called auto schedule. Now, auto schedule, if you press it, essentially finds the next available recommended slot based on the context of the task and automatically plots it in for you. So as you can see there, it's nudged that up for me. Now, it is based around a few different things. So for example, if this right report came in as urgent, it replaces that task, if that makes sense, quite quickly. So you don't have to have that. You can actually stop auto scheduling it pretty instantly. But if it did say, for example, this one came in as urgent and this one was normal, and you changed a few attributes around, you can see that it quickly changes back and is a bit more adaptive. So this isn't the only sort of auto planning task blocking type thing. You can also click into a task and see the task, but you can also see a thing called planning mode. You could do this by just simply blocking time that it recommends you've got free. So for example, I could block it there, and as you can see, it's gone into a focus time period. Now, this is great because it connects to the task and it's sort of two-way synced between it and the likes of ClickUp, which is very, very helpful. Did you know that over 1.3 million people use Zapier with AI? This can help you save time, optimize repetitive tasks, and get more done. Zapier helps you to create workflows and automation by building simple or complex workflows and connecting nearly 8,000 integrations. Zapier is one of the leaders in AI automation, and that's why over 3.4 million companies use Zapier to get things done. Get started today for free down in the link in the description. Now, this one, if you click into it, you have to confirm the work session. So it's an AI suggestion, and then you have to confirm it to turn it into what I just did with the planning. You also have the ability to see overdue items in which you can change stuff. And there is a feature down here that's sort of missed. It's called suggestions, and it'll help you to prioritize it, add a due date, and allow you to start organize it into your calendar. Now down here, there's a way to meet with other people. So if I press meet with, say this, I can go and block a period of time and recommend the slot, send the invite and connect up with Google Meet, which is a great time saver. And you notice as well, everything is based on event, focus time, or out of office, which is very helpful for those trying to block their calendar. Now, in terms of features, that's really nice in terms of how they set that up. It's not Motion or AccuFlow or those level of applications in terms of blocking time and focus, in my opinion, but it does a light amount, more like Flow Savvy, which is another application on the market, and it does connect with multiple calendars. Now, as you can see here, you can also use something called AI Note Taker. Now, I'm not going to explain an AI Note Taker to you. If you're looking for AI Note Takers, I'd recommend finding the link in the description to the video or browsing toolfinder.co to explore more AI Note Takers. But as you can see, there's an introductory price for 50% off. Now, as you can see, it is based on the hours that you have per month. So if you have 60 hours of meetings, $12 is $6 per user based on 1 to 2 users. So one user is $6, and that's actually fairly reasonable and you can continue to check out. But there are some pretty mighty and beefy plans like 12,000 hours, and you can connect them up. So you can start to see how helpful it is if you're bolting this onto your ClickUp account, and it'll just automatically connect to the meetings that you have. So again, very much integrated and very useful. Now, I want to point out a few flaws of this application. Whilst the general design is not too bad, it's quite approachable. And actually this on this left-hand side, despite being fairly cluttered in what you've got, the auto-scheduling works relatively well. And I like how it automatically suggests a few different dates. But what I found with this app is I was able to set up stuff in my Google Calendar and it didn't sync incredibly fast. I know many people have had syncing issues with ClickUp, and actually the syncing isn't that fast, and the load speed of certain screens in the calendar experience isn't that fast. They're obviously trying to bake in a lot of stuff in here, but it's just something I noted and probably something that you'd be made aware of if you're comparing it to something like Notion Calendar, because Notion Calendar is pretty clicky, whereas with ClickUp Calendar in terms of speed, it's not as clicky, but it does have the auto-scheduling function, which I think those apps don't have right now. So that was my opinions on ClickUp Calendar. The application is relatively easy to use, and you can find it in the link in the description if you find it useful, or you think, wow, I'm going to download it, use ClickUp in general, and just start playing with it and start baking it in, because it does have a free plan. This is free and accessible, which is great if you're looking for a calendar app that you don't want to spend money on initially, because some are like that. For example, Vimcal, you have to start spending money to really get access to the features beyond the mobile version. So again, it's really more approachable, but don't expect lightning speed when using it. So that was my review of ClickUp Calendar. If you're interested in more tools like this, you can jump over to toolfinder.co. There's loads of calendar apps on there, and maybe too many for you to browse, but hopefully we'll narrow down your options and find the one for you. So thank you so much for stopping by. I'll see you very soon, and cheerio for now.